I'm going to talk about IDMPR plugin for document management system. So I think in even our many of us may using document management system, but many people may not aware. So prior to working with IDMPR, I was working as Alfresco consultant, which is actually document management system. So we have done even integration with Alfresco and IDMPR, but there is always like having external document management systems is like bothering to, and it's not like we are not utilizing best out of both system. So it was like good idea in last conference we discussed, and it's actually Norbert suggested to have something in IDMPR so that user don't need to switch between two systems. There is no requirement for integrations. So we started developing this plugin, and still we haven't finished, but it is like at a usable state currently. So I would like to share means what is the document management system and how we can use it. So first I would like to thank this sponsor. So here is a list of sponsors who has actually sponsored like development efforts, and Chuck Norbert, who has actually contributed on testing DMS. So like DMS, correct? First question is why DMS, correct? So many business like who are dealing with the documents like contracts and lots of other documentations. If organization is dealing like a huge amount of documentations, then it is very hard to organize it and manage it, correct? So mostly your document are not independent. Those are actually related to your business data, correct? So how you are relate those document, and when you are actually in IDMPR or any ERP systems, you are actually working with your master's data or transactional data, how you can easily pull your related document, or how you can access your document easily, correct? That is very important. So when we do the third party integrations, it is not that much flexible because you need to go from one system to another system. And sometimes you need to like search again, same things, correct? So IDMPR DMS plugin solved that problem. So normally in DMS, correct, like DMS is normally main purpose is like organizing your document and making it very easily accessible. Also, none of the document management system currently handles like redundancy of document. But in IDMPR DMS plugin, we have tried to take care about like how we can make a document redundant. So we are not uploading same document multiple times, but we can access it from multiple places because mostly one document is associated with different records, correct? So multiple records it can associate. So next, DMS component, correct? So mostly what DMS, any document management system you go, they have these common features or common component. So one of them is a metadata. Metadata is actually when you have a like any document, any printed document or scanned document, you can search content, correct? It's not easy to search because content is inside your document. It is in maybe in proprietary format, or maybe it is like encrypted, any format. So what you need is actually you need to provide metadata, so later you can easily search it, easily find it, correct? So you need to provide metadata. So the one is a metadata. So in our plugin, we use our attribute set functionality of IDMPR to model our metadata. Second is version control. So version control is very important because if same document is like accessible to multiple people, it is obvious like we don't have a control who is modifying it. So we need to actually maintain a versions, correct? So if anybody modify document, it should not overwrite the previous version, but it should create new version. So it is auditable. It means anyhow you can go to the previous version and see like the new user what changes are made or what addition he has done. Second thing is a storage. So most of document systems are come with a storage, but we don't have a we can't spend that much effort. So what we keep, storage is like flexible. We say that you can store in either file system, on FTP, or S3, or in third-party DMS. Okay, you can develop your storage, okay, and just provide to DMS plugin, and DMS plugin don't need to know the underlying protocols of storage. Correct. So everything we created as a like interfaces, and as a factory. So everything is published by services. Correct. So storage is like we haven't developed any storage, but we provide provisioning for like storing your content in any kind of storages. So by the default we have a file system storage. So storage currently, whatever we are supporting as a storage provider, as attachment storage provider and archive storage provider, those will work with DMS because we are using same concept.
Debug question, do you have a locking mechanism to prevent two users opening the document at the same time? So they start both working on the same document like in a fork and saving it then back basically?
No, we don't have that currently.
Okay.
Yeah. IDMPR don't have, means record locking is there, but yeah, but here your document record is non-editable, means is once you upload any document, it is non-editable. You always create new version. Correct. So even you try to upload, a new version will be created. So your previous version will always there, and you can look your version history. Yeah, that's required. Means checking and checkout features required, but we don't have.
Exactly.
Yeah. Alfresco has normally that. Indexing. So, for indexing, we are using Solr. This is again general component of any DMS system. They index the content and metadata to retrieve it easily. So currently we are using Solr, but again indexing also we have like providers for indexing. So we always follow like concept like as Diego mentioned, like we have a definition plugin and we have a implementer plugin. So for indexing we have a like a definition plugin, we say Logilite search, and then we have a Solr implementer plugin. Correct. So same how like for indexing. So why we choose Solr instead of Lucene is due to the reason that many of our customers, correct, are actually using a farm, server farm. So we don't want to keep anything local to a application server. So Solr is actually providing REST services to access the index and build index, correct? So that's why we went for a Solr. So that's how we can have a dedicated or shared application in Solr server from where your index resides. These two red one, correct, are still not implemented. So that's why this is normally common features of any document management system. But these two is still pending. So one is a workflow enabling and access management. So in access management, we have a very simple mechanism. Yes, Chuck? Okay. So we have very simple mechanism is like if you have access to your tables or record, correct, you get access to attached document, means whatever is related to those records, you get access. But we haven't implemented any other access mechanism currently. And workflow is completely pending. So normally in any document management systems, like workflow is normally triggered whenever something is happened, like you upload document, a workflow may triggers, correct, and then a flow of like editing or anything happens, correct. So we haven't worked on workflow integrations. So these two things are major features of DMS that are missing. Access management, we can say that we have partly, because we have a like one window, we say document explorer, that give you access to all the document, but it can be controlled by role menu access. And second is we have a form which is pop up from your toolbar that is actually can show only documents which are associated with current record. You can't go beyond that, means if your document is not associated, you can't go, or you can't go back and you can navigate those. So, yes. Yes.
So I know those are red, and I know these boxes are not implemented. It's actually implemented, in my humble opinion, quite well. So the vast, in my experience, the majority of my customers use DMS as a replacement to the standard paperclip. And because that, like you said, that pop-up defines that experience, they can get access to those attachments unless they have access to the rest of that record. Window, so forth and so on. So for that reason, I love it. The second thing is workflow. I do what Pedro said. IDMPR requests are amazing. They're absolutely amazing. You can have star configuration, you can have serial configuration, you can have logic, depends on an approved request. And so as an example, I'll have a customer who does their personnel raises in IDMPR, they'll attach the documents to their raise record. They'll use the request to float it around. If anyone sees the request, it doesn't matter because the document's held inside that one window and that one record that only specific people can see. So from my perspective, those are gold, not red, but they work quite well.
Yeah, so even role access management means when we are drafting design, actually there are lots of options. And lots of opinion. Okay, so people who are familiar with like Linux file systems, they would like to have a role access, like something is like directory level or something, correct? Means in structure, because in DMS you can structure your content also. You can create directories, subdirectories, correct? And you can structure content also. If you have a use number of document associating to same record, you can structure it. So sometimes people think like I have a different kind of contents, okay, and I want a specific group of people have access to specific folder, correct, and it derive the access from there. So from parent, all child directories should derive access, correct. That is normally how Windows or Linux work, correct. So some opinion is like access mechanism should be like that. And some opinions, like some customers want, like it should be associated with just record, correct? Because if you have access to a particular record, okay, user should able to see the associated documents. So it depends on domain to domain. So currently we have implemented a simple mechanism, is like if you have access to a particular record, then you can see document associated with that.
The place where these documents are stored, is that on the database server or on S3 server?
It can be anywhere. Okay, means currently we have provided S3 and file system support. That is, and FTP support. These three storage provider are there. It is even in out of IDMPR we have a S3 and file systems. Mm-hmm. So currently wherever attachment can be stored, your document can be stored, correct? But means you can use that providers, okay? But you can have a different path or different URL, correct? So you can create your own storage provider and you define where it should go. Now, still that I haven't get any request like I want to store into like document containers like Alfresco have, okay? But if somebody want, we can create a storage provider for that. And you have like storage provider in it's going into your Alfresco container. So everything is possible because it's all are like interfaced. So currently what features we have is like a metadata modeling. So we can do the if you are dealing with a different kind of contents, correct, it may have a different kind of metadata. So those metadata you can models. So we have a features or content type. So when you define a content type, you define what metadata associated with those particular content type. And whenever you are uploading content, as per your metadata model, system asks for providing those metadata. Also, we have created a plugins which like system generated documents where it automatically populate metadata. For example, many people may using the archive features into IDMPR. But when you are looking for document in archive store, it is very difficult. You have to just next browse, correct? It's not easy. You can search. So what we have done is we have created a archive store provider which is stored into a DMS system. So now your archive document, you can search into DMS and you can search like anything like customer, document number, any things, correct, that is associated metadata, you can search by those. So second is version controlling. So we have currently features of version control. That is another features that all DMS system required. Content manager. So content manager is like many times, like when we are thinking about storage, there are different opinions. Sometimes people say that my content should be encrypted. Sometimes people say that even system is not working, I have a backup, I should be able to go and navigate my content. Correct? So structuring content is everyone has a different requirement. So content management like will take care about those. So we have a created a like providers, correct? You can write your own provider. We structure your content. So default structure is like currently we are supporting structures like attachment do. So it is like you have a tenant, table ID, record ID, and your content, correct? That is a normal default one. Second, we have a relational content manager. So relational content manager is do like how you are structuring your content into a DMS or how you are seeing into DMS. It replicates same things into file system. So your directory structures, how you are seeing into DMS is same replicated into actual file storage. So there are different way of organizing your content. Second thing is like we can view as a like, so while I'm talking about this, let's take a look also. So we know like what we are talking about. So this is actually Document Explorer icon. Okay, so this is user interface of Document Explorer. So normally when you open it from a Document Explorer, you are getting root level access. So normally this menu, correct, it should not be open for all user, because if you make it open, then all documents are accessible to all users. So that's why it's not suggested. Now, whenever you are actually on any window and you are looking at records, correct, on toolbar, you get this toolbar button is a Document Explorer. When you open it, you can see only the content or document which are associated with this particular record. Okay, so if we are looking into Document Explorer, we were able to see like lot of things, correct, but here you can't see this whole stuff, because if you navigate here, correct, you will find out like in Business Partner, you will find out those same content. Okay, but when anybody opens from any records, correct, whatever is associated with that particular record are visible. So we have two things here. So one is this view, and second is actual content viewer. So once you click, double click on this, it launches a content viewer. So the content viewer itself extendable. So currently we are supporting all image, a PDF viewer, text viewer, but you can create your own viewer because we don't know means how many MIME types, correct? Or some company may be dealing with AutoCAD files and they may have access to some commercial tool, yeah?
So which API are you using for this content viewer? I'm just curious because, for example, we use a LibreOffice API just to render docs, Excel, and stuff. That's how I'm curious, what are you using to render this one?
Currently, we are not using that one, but we are using PDF viewer that is out of Chrome. Whenever unknown content type means viewer is not available for those MIME type, it's only show as a like downloadable icon. Okay, so you can download and you can view in external tools. But this viewer is extendable, means for any MIME types, correct, you can create your own viewer. And you deploy, so if DMS finds that for those MIME type of viewer is available, it just launch through those viewer. So regarding version control, correct? So let me take an example of a PDF document. So I'm creating a directory. Not like to cast. Okay, so let me upload a file. Okay, so here when we are uploading a document type, it asks for a DMS content type. So when you select content type, like for example, I have defined as a contract document, correct? So whenever I select that, this form will renders all the metadata that required for a contract document. So I have currently defined like a valid from customer and who signed this document. Correct. So you can define your own metadata by using attribute set. So for defining that, what normally let me first upload this, and I say, this is valid from today. Customer is Joy Block. And Garden had been signed it. Oops. We have some mess up. It's on server. Okay, so whenever you are uploading this, actually this metadata is actually getting associated with your content, and we are also like we have a mechanism to extract actual document content. So we index metadata as well as document content. So currently we are providing PDFs, text file, and Word document and Excel sheet. So from XLS we are able to extract content, and docx we are able to extract those content, and text file and PDF. So in PDF again, if it is a simple scan, then we are not able to extract, but the PDF which are normally printed from a Chrome or something, we are able to extract those. So we extract those content also and we index it. So you can search inside the content of document. Tops on?
If you have, let's say, a partner, and you should add the new tab. Mm-hmm.
So earlier we have only tab, correct? Now we have given an option here. So both options are there. You can open Explorer from here, or you can have a sub tab. So as a DMS tab, you can add. So here, once you are opening this document, here you have a version history. So if version are attached, correct, so you can navigate here and you can download any previous version. Regarding searching, correct, searching document, we have two options, like one is a generic search, which search across all metadata, and advanced search. For advanced search, we have to select content type, and you have a you have all your metadata. You can search for specific metadata also, correct? And so these all are search features. Second thing is if we go into a client info, we have an archive storage provider, correct? So we have created a DMS archive storage provider. In archive store, we can specify DMS archive storage provider, and if you are using this, then whenever you are archiving document, it's go to DMS instead of database. Okay, so this whole features, another features are I will go quickly because already we are running out of. So we have created Java API. Yeah, we can do that. But I can go through features, so just we talk generally, and then we demo we can do in workshop. Yeah. So we, Java API, the archive store, correct, is using Java API, because many times you are generating documents inside IDMPR, then how you access DMS, that is done by Java API. Associating a document with records, even you can associate document with document. So we have created association type. So you can say that this is a document and you have a associated amendment or attachment. Then archive to DMS, DMS subtab both Nobert talk. We can have a subtab as a DMS and indexing document content, correct? So this is all current features.
Quick question.
Yes.
One, are you following any JSR standards for the document management API?
Not currently. There are a CMIS standard for interface, correct? So that is in roadmap. We haven't worked on that, but here in roadmap I mentioned. Okay. So this is all about it. Now in detail we can discuss in workshop. And thanks for giving chance. This was not scheduled.